Well, you know, these things happen. I had it recording and then I had to turn my timer on because I don't have another clock in here to time myself when it comes to stirring up my resin, and I was not about to have a problem. So yeah, that's where we're at right now. So I've got about 24 ounces of resin already on my canvas, and now I'm going to come back and I'm going to add the rest of this because I just didn't want to use a super large container to mix all of this up in. I don't think I'd have the shoulder strength to stir it, actually. So it is what it is. Okay! Okay, that's already got a lot in there. I may actually have a bit too much resin. So let's quickly figure that out. I actually don't mind if this has a really thick coat on it. This is a pour for my daughter. So I actually don't mind if there is a lot of resin on the top layer. I also normally use a spatula to do this part, but I figured this actually might be fun to do this way tonight. Although I feel like my hands are not going to have nearly as much fun. Get like incredibly messy up in here. So ooh, look at that. I love how the resin just brings everything back to life. So pretty. Yes. Combustion and noise and riffraff going on in the back parking lot of the restaurant here tonight. I wonder if they had like a party or something. I'm just going to take this resin to the edge here a little bit. Bring some of this resin from the center up and out. Never seem to keep my finger out of the inside. So pretty. There is really something pretty about coating your paintings in resin. You know? probably a little bit more tedious of a project to do than, say, using varnish. Although varnish can be a little temperamental itself, because varnish tends to, if you don't use the right paintbrush, it will go everywhere, in the sense of you will have lines going in every direction. Just very, very gently bring the resin over towards these edges here. And then I'll bring the resin off the edge, just so that edge can really start to kind of cascade overwards. All right, now I'm just gonna kind of pull my resin to these sides here. Just wanna make sure that I get all of the puddles, these little craters that form as the resin starts to cure and pulls itself away. These little areas that are like, no, I refuse to give in. Help them give in anyway. Now it looks as if I have got every area covered with the exception of my edges, which is perfect because that's what we want. Oh, I found another spot. So you'll bring the resin over the edge just ever so delicately. Kiss, you kiss the edge with the resin. I'm just going to come back and trail the edge here. It's not going to be perfect by any means, it's not going to be perfect. But what I'm trying to do is just kind of invite the resin over the edge here. Okay. Then I'm going to take my finger and wipe off the edge here. Put that over here. And this is actually my favorite part. The resining. Getting these yummy little edges here. It's almost like finger painting. And I can't get enough of it. Just gonna very gently just kiss the edge with the canvas. Make sure you get all of that part covered. You don't want any bubbles or any pieces of canvas kind of hanging off. So that's why you'll see me like rub it, and then I'll come back and gently glaze over it. This is just ensuring that those little, you know, pieces, those little pivots of canvas that create the texture are getting resined as well. And I like there to be a pretty decent coat so that my fingers can just really glide off of that spot. I don't want any resistance or traction pulling off of my finger, because that tells me that the piece is not completely resined yet on the sides and that it's not ready. We probably have about 5 ounces, maybe 3 ounces. It's not very much in this cup because these are just the sides. The sides don't need to be like, you know, red carpet ready. You just want them to have a nice shine to them so that if they're sitting in the sunlight or if the light cascades on them, they don't look weird because they don't have resin on them. I was actually super disappointed in this canvas. After I ended up painting it, the side of the actual canvas separated from the wood. And normally I'd be pretty upset about that, but I'm not. There are certain things in life that have really taught me what to be upset about and what not to be upset about. And I know for a fact that this client is not going to be upset about this, so don't worry about it. Now I do want a little bit more resin on this side because it is not as glossy as I would like it. I want my fingers to move a little bit quicker. There we go. All right, coming around to the last corner here. And sometimes when you're working with the gloves, you know, they'll leave a little, like a, almost like a tread mark from where the, you know, the gloves fold over and such, which that happens. Right, so then just grab your glove and pull them real taut. So you can minimize it as much as possible. It's not going to be perfect, but these again are the sides, so they don't have to be perfect. Oops, sorry guys. I'm gonna come under here real quickly and I'm just gonna grab this extra resin. Let's keep it right back into the cup. You're darn right I did. Come around these edges here, around the table, and do the exact same thing. Because those extra drips that are left on there, what will happen is it will cause your resin to continue to pull, and then it'll make your sides uneven. All right, there are a few spots that need more resin added to them. So we're gonna come around here and make sure they get them. Don't want any edges showing up that need to be covered in resin more. They need to be covered in resin, they need to be covered in resin. Don't be tinkering with mama. And then the only other issue that I may run into, of course, for me hanging up and all over the piece, is I may end up with some random little hairs. But again, this client is a very, very good friend of mine. I think we got it. My gosh, I think we got it. All right, let me get the rest of this resin out. I'm not about wasting resin. Okay. completely clean hands. Let's torch this bad boy.
Yes!
A little bit higher of a torch, I think, actually. Just gotta be careful not to burn it. And it's going to pull all those bubbles up. Another reason I wear a tank top I'm working in the studio is because the material just kind of clings to you. And then when you go to do the sides, just turn down your torch so that you don't actually end up burning your canvas piece on the side. Good golly, she's pretty. The microphone really picks up the torch sound. I only know that from watching other artists. So I'm super sorry about that. I really love this. This is just unbelievable. You don't get to see half of this when it's not resined. I don't even think varnish pulls it out like this. I'm going down to the table. I don't want to catch anything on fire. So just kind of come along the edge here just to make sure all the bubbles are kind of popped on the edges here. Literally just a quick one over it does the trick every time. The only other thing, like I said, you got to just come back and check on the bubbles. Oh my goodness. I'm so glad that didn't hit the painting. You just hang tight like that, home skillet. I am so happy with this. Excuse me. All right, let's come under these edges here real quick. Get all this extra resin pulled off because there is a ton of it. Oops. And because it's curing, oh no, stay down. Oh no, oh no, oh no. What did I just do? It should be fine, because that's not going to touch it. For those of you who are wondering, I put paper towels underneath of my artwork tonight because I have a shower curtain on the table today instead of my silicone mats. Well, once I get access to my Christmas presents, I am hopeful that Santa brought me the cloud mat by Fluid Art Company. Because if they did, or if he did, good old Santa Claus, then I will have a 40 by 60 mat to work on. I just did a huge circle to go to the trash can. That was priceless. Okay, I'm going to pause you guys, and then I'm going to bring you down for a close-up. Oh, look how gorgeous this is. I love how the colors just fade into the blue. Oh, mama's happy. You know what they say. Happy wife, happy life. Oh my gosh. Ooh, look at those babies. Oof, 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 oof. Look at that hot pink. I think this is kind of upside down. This is upside down compared to how I poured it. She's going to be so happy with those magentas and those corals. Oh my gosh. It really looks like thermal ocean flooring. Oh, so pretty. All right, should we turn the studio lights off? Let's do that. I don't think that my camera is going to be able to hang because there's just not enough light to give it the availability to focus. Look how fucked up that is. Yeah, my studio is a mess. Like, it is a damn mess. Like, holy moly, somebody's been in here painting. Me! Let's stand up on the chair. Yes! Except for the fact that there's a light in the way, but that's okay. I'll just bend backwards a little bit more. All right, well, here she is.